Hello and welcome. You're watching a Money 9 special. I am Krishna Kumar. Before we go any further, make sure you're subscribed to our YouTube channel. Follow us across all social media platforms, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and Instagram. @ Money 9 Live is our handle. You can also log on to our website, www.money9.com, for all the latest from the world of personal finance. Time now for a Money 9 special. On this Money 9 special, we're being joined by Dr. A. Velumani of Thyrocare. Dr. Velumani, thank you so much for being with us. Yes, the big news at this time is what happened with Thyrocare. It is the biggest healthcare deal in India's healthcare space. But we want to discuss completely something else with you. And that is your own personal take on how people should be spending their money. Chiefly, your take on why it is better to not buy a house, because that's the first thing that you had tweeted out after the mega deal was signed. You've even done a Clubhouse special as well. Talk to us about your philosophies, from your own personal experience. You are somebody who's one of the most successful entrepreneurs in the country. Your company has been so successful, but you say that you never bought a house. How?
Thank you for having me on the show. Yes, it is a mega deal, and it is that this Madrasi is being a part of the deal, so it gives me both pleasure and pressure. The issue which we will discuss is why Velumani did not buy a house at all. Yeah, in that way, I came to Mumbai. Mumbai is costly. You can't dream of buying a house, so there was no dream only to buy a house. Then I started living as a paying guest, as a bachelor. 4 years went, got married. My wife was then working with State Bank of India. So two salaries, two good salaries. Everyone would have immediately gone out and hired out a flat. I didn't do that. I continued to remain as a paying guest instead of a bachelor, a married man. In fact, all directors of Thyrocare have lived in that house as a paying guest in a 300 square feet room. For some reasons, I didn't feel that a big house is needed, because only when you want to do a dikawa, that you are comfortable, rich, you buy a big house. So I lived for 10 years as a paying guest, which means I have managed all my family financial challenges only by saving money. So that's the first phase. Then the house buying as a dream was also around. But then I felt if I buy a house, I will have a 20 years of EMI. And if I have an EMI, I won't be able to take, the financial freedom is not what is achieved by EMI. In fact, you have to mortgage all your freedom, heart, mind, brain, everything for buying a house. I didn't want to do it. I didn't do it. So this is very unique. When I had to leave BRC as a temptation which came, I felt I don't have an EMI, so I am free to move around, and I moved around. Having said that, buying a house with money in hand is a wonderful asset. But buying a money with EMI puts you into tremendous minus points. This point no one agrees. I don't agree with everyone. I have a way of telling, mujhe jo chahiye wo main waisa hi karunga jaisa chahiye. So I did my own way. Fortunately my wife did not have an ego. She felt what you think is right, and I was blessed with a wife who felt my philosophy is best philosophy.
Well, I'd be interested to see what people watching this, how they make up their mind from your personal experience. Your story itself is an inspiring story. I want to quickly touch upon that as well. Thyrocare is like an example of how to build a business. It has built such a strong business, which has done so well during the pandemic as well. In fact, improved its business during the pandemic. And then at the end of all of it, you decided to let go. You've heard of things like the monk who sold the Ferrari. This seems to be one of those things. how and why did this happen? When you made all the money, when you built all the business, figured out exactly what is the best thing to do. How did you have the mind and the heart to give it away?
I think in life, I have read somewhere, you should be able to attach and detach as you wish. Very difficult. Saying is very difficult. But in practice, it is very, very challenging. According to me, attachment is all the reason for pains. And for me, company ThyroCare is a company which I have created. I know one day I will not be there, company will be there. I know one day someone else have to take care of. So I understood the opportunity. I understood what is that it is put on my table. And I felt it's done. I have done a game, a wonderful journey. With 500 rupees, I came to Mumbai. And today it's a 7,400 crore company. And I feel that that journey itself is sufficiently large. My parents are no more. Otherwise, they would not be knowing how many zeros it has got. Even my mother will ask, "Itna paisa ghar pe kahan rakhega?" To that extent, they were innocent. So I'm pretty well done with it. And greed is not good for anyone. Two things which causes damage and takes away the peace of mind. One is greed, another is ego. Greed will make you sleepless. Ego will make you suffer. So these two things were not there. So I took a decision. And I always take a decision which everybody will wonder, "Ye pagal hai." Bas, I have done it.
You know, strangely, your philosophy when it comes to your business of this idea of detachment seems to be, overflowing into, or rather, be similar to your approach to buying a home as well. You do not want to be attached to it at the end of the day. As long as you're living in a comfortable space with a peace of mind, you will be able to pursue life more fulfillingly, seems to be your fundamental take on life.
No, life is a very, very, unpredictable. I never thought when I was sitting in a Jayanti Janta Express S9 coach, 41 seat, I will ever be an MD of a listed company in Mumbai. So it's not anything. Hum jo sochte hain, wo kabhi hota nahi hai. Jo ho jata hai, wo kabhi socha bhi nahi hai. So if you ask me, life is very, very uncertain in terms of what it has for us, either it is opportunities or challenges. But having said that, lage raho, jaage raho, it will be a very wonderful journey. I have seen this entire journey where things happening very fast, and it is up to you to adapt it. There are three kinds of people. One gets disrupted, the other disrupts, the third one gets self-disrupted. So if you look at the deal I have agreed, is a self-disruption. And I must tell you, there is no better fun than self-disrupting. I am from a very small village, was very poor. I have seen the zero. When I say I have started from the zero, everybody only is worried about zero. I am not worried about zero because I was there and I know what it is. So if you are scared, I tell it like this, let the pain come. When it comes, don't have the pain, the fear of that pain which has still not come. That means you will have courage to take decisions. And jo kona chahta hai, wo kabhi khota nahi hai. Jo kone se darta hai, वो कभी पाता नहीं है. तो बी अवेक, बी अलर्ट, टेक रिस्क. विदाउट रिस्क देर इज नो स्टोरी. ब्रेक कन्वेंशन एंड डू समथिंग डिफरेंट. व्हेन यू हैव एन ऑप्शन टू चूज, चूज व्हाट इज डिफिकल्ट टू डू, डोंट चूज व्हाट इज इजी टू डू. इफ यू कीप ऑन चूजिंग व्हाट इज डिफिकल्ट टू डू, वन डे यू विल बी इन द टॉप ऑफ द पिरामिड.
All right, we will leave it at that on that wonderful note. Dr. A. Velumani, thank you so much for being with us here on this Money 9 special. It's a wrap on this Money 9 special. For more specials like this, keep it with Money 9. Follow us across all social media platforms, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, and Instagram. @RateMoneyNineLive is our handle. Log on to our website, www.moneynine.com, for all the latest from the world of personal finance. For now, this is Krishna Kumar. Signing off.